So the first thing we're doing is just adding scenery to the scene. I already have like a tree, so I'm just going to do an example of a couple other things. So one will be an animated piece of scenery, and the other one will just be a static piece of scenery. So most of this is going to be in Pascal, but I'm going to open up Godot first so that we can see what I've got so far. So I'm just opening Godot. I'm going to open my game and click edit. And when it first opens up, there's nothing open. It just opens to this blank scene. And so I have to open my scene. I'm going to go to the scenes folder and go to my first scene. And I'm just going to keep building in here for now. I'll probably add some more stuff in here later to or add more scenes maybe today or later. But for now, I'm just going to keep building on this first scene. So I have a little bit of scenery. I have these like two parts of my forest. And so I want to add a couple more scenic components in here. And so I want to go over a couple different types. So the tree is pretty straightforward. We already went over like how to make variations of the tree. I can duplicate the tree and change the color. And I can make multiple copies of this tree group and move them around. So I can like move this whole group around if I want to. So we already kind of talked about that. I'll go over that a little bit when I make my new things. But I want to talk about a couple other types of scenery. One is like animated scenery. We can have some animated scenery if we want to. So I'm going to make like a little bird to put in the trees. And then the other thing is sometimes scenery actually tells us stuff about the game. So I'm going to make some scenery that's just like some little arrows that give our character like a direction to go in. So that kind of falls into functionality, but it's kind of in the middle between functionality and scenery. Because it doesn't, we can't interact with them necessarily, or we don't have to. So they're part of the scenery, but they can kind of give us a direction. So scenery is part of creating the game world, but it is also part of showing us where we should be going in the game. So I'm going to close Godot for now, and I'm going to go over to Pascal. And so I'm not going to go over making a tree. I think you guys can figure that out. So I'm just going to start with my animated scenery. So I'm going to make a little bird. So I'm going to go ahead and save my file first. And usually I write the type of sprite I'm creating at the beginning of the file name. So I'll say like scenery bird. This will make it easier to find later when I put it into my project. So I'm going to click Save As and go to Art. And now I'm going to make a new folder for my scenery. So I'm going to create a new folder, call this Scenery, and go in here. And so I'm just going to make a really simple bird. I have my little drawing tablet that I'm going to use, but it's going to be super, super simple. And I'm just going to do a couple of frames so I can animate the bird. So let's see, 32 by 32. So let's choose a color for the bird. Maybe I'll do something like pink so it kind of stands out against the green trees. Something like that. I guess not a lot of birds are pink. There's probably some pink birds. Let's see. Pink bird. Oh, there's flamingos. That's probably the most obvious one. This one's kind of cool though. Let's see. What is this
Flamingos and
one?
other birds that eat shrimp, they turn pink.
Oh, really? That's really
Yeah.
interesting. Wow. So maybe I should add some shrimp too. I'll just start with the bird. So I'm gonna do a really bad version of this little bird guy. Let's make a little guide first. So I'll have like a head and a body, and I'll probably have like a tail up here like that, and some legs, and maybe like a couple wings like that. So that'll be my guide. And let's go to the next frame and draw it in. So here's the outline of the bird. Let's fill that in. And here's my tail. And I'll probably use some like shading to fill in the details. And let's give the bird a couple feet. And then like a couple wings here. And then I'm gonna use my light and darken tool to add some details. So I usually will hold shift and let's add some eyes. Actually, I wanna make it darker. So let's hold control and shift, add some eyes. That's too big. Let's add an eye. And then I'll add another darken there. And then I'll add like a beak. That looks pretty bad. Try that again. Okay, there's the beak. Doing too many. Okay, and I'll put some details in the feathers back here, and I'll outline the wings a little bit. And that looks pretty good. This is just scenery, so I don't want it to stand out like too much. So I just want to make this animate a little bit so I could like maybe move the tail around, or I could move the eyes around. I'm going to duplicate a couple frames. Actually, let's just duplicate it once, and I'm going to erase the tail. So I'm just going to animate the tail a little bit, just so it like looks like it's alive. It'll give the game a little bit more life. So go back to this frame, and let's see. Let's make the tail go kind of up like this a little bit. And I'll add in some highlights here. And remember, you guys are probably better at drawing than I am. You can probably do something that looks better than this. But I'm just kind of demonstrating. Okay. And so let's turn the animation frames back on and see what it looks like. So that's pretty good. I'm gonna get rid of this outline. Okay, that's pretty cool. I'll probably put a little delay in Godot, but this is good enough for my bird animation. I'm gonna save this. And since I have this, I have the main file, but I also wanna export this to Godot. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. I'm gonna export, and I'll just click download. And so I'm gonna find my game folder, go to game, go to sprites. And so now, I'm just gonna leave this in here. So there's different ways to organize this, but just to make it easier to find things, everything is gonna go into the sprites folder, but since it has scenery at the beginning, it'll be easy to find because it'll be organized by what type of sprite it is. So I have all my characters that will line up together, and then all my scenery will be in the same place. So I'm gonna save here. And now I'm just gonna make like a little sign. But I'll show you something that I can do with the sign is have multiple sprites, but I don't actually have to animate it. So that's another way that I can use a sprite sheet. So I'm going to actually just go ahead and make a new Pascal window and get rid of my bird. Okay. And I'm going to go ahead and save as usual. So I'm going to say scenery, and I'm going to call this a sign. So the sign can like say stuff, like you could say like danger. Actually, I'm gonna put multiple signs here. So let's say signs. You can say like, you know, go this way. I'm just gonna use arrows just to kind of keep it simple. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make one sign and I'm gonna put different stuff on it. So I'm gonna start with an outline as usual. I'll just put like a little box for my sign. And I'll put like a little pedestal thing for it to sit on. Kind of looks like a TV, but that's okay. And so then I'll go to the next frame and let's choose a color. So I want it to stand out. So I might choose like, maybe I'll do like orangish to have a different color scheme. I don't know how, I might have to change the colors later, but we'll start with orange. We can always fix it later. And so I'm going to draw the outline first. Oops, I'm still in line mode. Let's go to pen mode. I'm going to draw this outline and then draw my little pedestal. And then I'm going to fill this in with a slightly lighter color. So I'm going to take a lighter version of this color and then get the paint bucket and fill it in. And that looks pretty good. Let's fix the pedestal a little bit. Okay. That's probably too much, actually. Let's get rid of it. Okay. Let's turn the onion skin off. So that looks pretty good. So I'm going to make a few versions of this. So I'm going to duplicate this frame. So again, this isn't going to be an animation, but I can use the same sign and have it doing different things. So my first sign, I'll just have an arrow that like points to the right. It's a pretty bad arrow. Draw that again. So let's do like that. There we go. That's a bit better. And then we'll have a sign that points to the left. So we can use this to kind of give our character directions if we want to. Pretty bad arrow. One more time. There we go. And then we can have like an up arrow and a down arrow. So this I can use to give my character like explicit instructions about where to go in the scene if I need to. And we'll talk about this a little bit more when we talk about level design, about how to lead the character through a level. Sometimes just giving them explicit signs is an easy way to do it. I'm going to save this. It's already saved. I'm going to export. And so I'll click downloads, and it should go here. So scenery is at the beginning, so it's going to be sitting next to my birds. I'm going to save this, and that looks pretty good. So I'm done with the art for this part, so I'm going to X out of here, and I'm going to go back to Godot. And now if I look in sprites, I should see my new sprites. There's the bird, and there's the scenery. So now I want to add these into my scene. So let's add a new, so I have these two forest parts. I want to make this sure this is organized. So I'm going to add a scenery node again so that all this stuff is in the scenery. So I'm going to right click on my first scene and I'm just going to add a just generic node 2D and rename this scenery. And I'm going to put all of my scenery in here. So I'm going to put this above the player and then I'm going to throw the forest, both of these in here. And now I'm going to add more stuff. So I'm going to add another child node 2D and call this birds. And then I'm going to add another one and call this signs. So I'm just making this nice and organized. I can collapse this scenery node. And so now I see just the main two parts of my scene so far, the scenery and the player. But if I open the scenery node with this little arrow, now I see my different forests and the birds that I'm about to add, as well as the signs. So I'm going to select the birds. I'm going to lock up my little forest guy for now. Select the birds. And now I'm going to add an animated sprite. So remember, my bird is animated, and I can add an animated sprite directly into my scene. So I'm going to hit plus here and type in sprite. And this is an animated sprite, so I'll click create. And I'm just going to call this bird. And I'm probably have multiple birds, so let's call this bird one. And so we've already gone over creating an animated sprite in our character animation lab, but we're just going to review again. So I'm going to click on the bird animated sprites, click on empty, go to new sprite frames, click on sprite frames, and now I get my animation frames. I'm not going to be controlling the bird with a script, so I don't really care what the animation is called. So I'm just going to leave it on default. And so remember to add frames to my animation. I just click on the waffle button here. And so I'm going to go to sprites and choose the bird and click open. And let's zoom in on the bird a bit. And so I'm going to switch this to 2x2 and select the three bird frames. And then click add three frames. And so the one thing I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this first frame a few times so that the bird does not isn't constantly animated. And then I just have to turn this on. So notice the bird isn't animating yet. I'm going to click on the bird and turn playing on. And there we go. Now I have a little bird. The bird is as big as the character, which may look a little weird, but that's fine. I'm just gonna leave it as is. So I'll put a couple little birds. The birds are also as big as the trees. So that looks a little weird. I should probably make the trees bigger so that the birds can sit in the trees, but I'm not gonna do that right now. So I'll just add a couple birds. So again, if I want to duplicate something, I just hit Control D, or you can right click and go to duplicate. So I have another bird, and I'm just gonna drag that one over here, and I'm gonna make another one, drag it down here. So I just have some birds. They're probably too big, but whatever. If later I'll go in and scale things correctly, but for now this is good enough. So now I have some stuff going on with the birds, and now I'm going to add some signs. So I haven't actually set up much in the scene yet, but let's imagine that I want my character to walk through this forest, and then over here there's going to be some type of like portal that takes them to the first level. So let's let the character know that's what we want them to do. So in the signs, I'm going to click the plus button and add just a regular sprite. This isn't animated. And I'm just going to put sign one. And this is going to be in the middle by default. And so to add the sign, I'm going to go over to the inspector and go to the texture, click empty, and click load, and go to my sprites. And here's my new scenery. And so when I add this, notice that there it has my whole sprite sheet, and I only want one of the signs, right? So this is another thing that we can do with our sprites. Even though we're not doing an animation, we can still use the animation settings to use just one of these signs. So the way that I do that in the inspector is I go to the animation area, and it has similar settings as when we're setting up our animation. So I just change the number of frames. So there's two horizontal frames and two vertical frames. And so now we just have one sign. So that looks pretty good. Let's put this over here. And I can also change the frame that it's on to get my different types of signs. So let's say we have our right hand sign right here. So when our player enters, we'll just tell them to go to the right. And then I'm going to duplicate that sign. So I'll hit Control D. And then I duplicated the sign. I'm going to drag it over here. And let's imagine that after we get over here, we want the player to go down. So with this sign, I'm going to go over to animation and change the frame to 3. So now this sign is the right pointing sign, and this sign is the down pointing sign. So we can use a sprite sheet not just to create an animation, but also to have multiple choices for the scenery for our sprites. Okay, so I'm almost done with this part. Let's take a little preview. Okay, so now there's my sign. Here's my forest. There's my overly large birds. Maybe I should just make them really big so it's sort of ridiculous looking. And here's my down arrow. So I'm starting to build out the scene a little bit. There's some directionality going on. There's some different stuff. So that's starting to look pretty good. Let's see. What if I make my birds like really big? Let's make them like. Now they're just like background parts, basically. Kind of funny. Okay. Anyway, another thing I could do with my sprites, remember that I can, oops. With my animations, I'm doing this in the code with my player, but I can also do this in my settings. So if I wanted to have one of my birds like facing a different direction, I can click on the bird and then I can go over here to the animated sprite properties, and I can click on flip H, which flips it horizontally. I can also do flip V, which flips it vertically if I wanted to do that. So I can make one of the birds face a different direction. And I can also, of course, modulate the color of the bird if I want to make them like slightly different colors to add a little bit more variation in here. Can be kind of fun. Okay. So, now for this part, I want to document this, and I'm not going to do the post quite yet. I'll do it a little bit later. But I'm going to play the scene, and just so I can have this to document later, I'm going to move this guy over here. And so I can document everything in my scene. So I'm going to hit the Windows G to open up the Xbox game bar. And I don't know actually if this gets captured by Discord, by, forget if this gets captured by, what's it called? OBS. But anyway, I'm hitting Windows G, and I'm just going to click on the capture screenshot. And so now I have another capture, and I'm going to click see my captures. Oh, and then I have to click on this little folder icon. And now I can see this capture that I just made. So I'll post this a little bit later. So I'm going to pause here. We're going to do a little bit more, but I'm going to do this in a second video.